I'm going to leave that the way it is. Okay. So now the other thing you always have to worry about is just because you have this kind of next to one another, it's not this and this will be next to another, one another, because then you're going to start putting in your other papers. So I have Tink and Peter Pan. Maybe I'll do those next. Now what I'm going to put these, I tend to do this a lot. I end up rearranging a lot of stuff. I think I'm going to go with that. Okay. So I'm going to put this off to the side while that kind of dries. We are now going to work on Tinkerbell and Peter Pan. And what I did was I, again, went into the little golden book. And as you can see, I cut out some pages that I had liked. Now I'm going to put Tink on the front. I'm going to put one of these on the front. I'm not opening that yet. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to work on this page first. So what I did was I took out the page where it says, "There was a place, a faraway place, where the sun always shone and the sky was always blue and no one ever grew old. This place was called Neverland and it was where Peter Pan and Tinkerbell lived." So I felt that was appropriate for the first page. So what I have been doing is, I gotta move some stuff out of the way, but I have been taking my watercolors and I have cheap watercolors. I think you can get these for like 10, 12 bucks or something at Michael's. And what I am going to do is paint around the edges and try and get a halfway decent color. So what I end up doing a lot of the times is mixing colors. So I'm going to mix a little bit of yellow. Yellow. We're going to do a little light green. And I have to tell you, these watercolors, oops, they give off a really good color. And I think we're going to go with this blue green. Okay. And the way I try to do this is, we're going to go, oh wait, we actually need blue. So we are going to go with a blue, a very light blue. And I'm going to mix it with a tiny little bit of this blue. That should be good. Okay. So on top, I'm going to, hopefully you can see this, I think you can. So I go in, and I try not to take too much water, because I don't want the paper to buckle. It's not real heavy cardstock, so. And I just lay some color down. And there's a little tiny little bit of green in there. So we're going to mix a little bit of green. So we have a little bit of a blue-green sky. And see what I'm trying to do? I'm trying to mix this in with what I am seeing. I mean, I could put this all the way down at the bottom. All right, we're going to go with a little bit more blue.
Spreading it around because I want striations, like you have the clouds, is basically what I'm doing.
Okay. Let's see where we are here. Do we need to do more? Nope, I'm good for the top. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this over, and I try to match the picture with the scenery. So, we are going to do a very, it's going to be a blue, if I can mix it with white. Meh. See how that looks. Doesn't look much different. But I think it'll work. So here's where I need my orange and my yellow. Going to need to be like that. I just try to make it look as continuous as possible. I mean, is it going to be perfect? No. Of course not, but okay, now we're going to move into the greens. Now this is like a lighter green, so I think what I'm going to do is add a little bit of white. There we go. Hmm. That's a little too dark. And this I'm just laying in the color. That's all I'm doing. Okay. So now we have a little like gray area here. That should work. There we go. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Lay that in. Okay. Now we need more blue, but I'm going to make this a little bit more with a hint of gray. See how that looks. It looks like nothing. There we go. It's not too bad. I'm just going to continue that down because I don't really want white. So, okay. But I don't always do this, but I just, when I saw this picture, I kind of went with the idea that I kind of wanted to have it continue. So, all I'm going to do is when I lay this down, I'm going to make sure I have a little spot here that needs to be colored. I don't know if I'm going to need these colors anymore, so what I do is I just take a little bit of my paper towel that I have over here on the side, and I just pull up the paint. And as you can see, one, two, three, your color is gone, and you can close up your lid. So, when you have these lids, I just use them as my paint tray. I'll put that on the other side. Okay. Alright. So, what I am going to do now is, I have to make sure that this is laying properly. And I am going to put down my score tape on the paper here. Now, here's the fun part. Okay. So now I have to line this up perfectly. All right, we're good. We are golden. Okay. And then if for any reason later on, if I need to go in and touch something up, I'll go and touch something up. Like here, I'm going to put a tiny little bit of glue. Yesterday I laid a pen down and I cannot find it for the life of me. Couldn't find it. Now, the next page to have Peter Pan is this one, okay? Now, I don't know. Do I want to put Peter Pan there? Or should I put Peter Pan here? But then what do I put here? I could put him there. Maybe we'll do that. You're like, what are you doing, Leslie? I get inspired by stuff I see as I'm working on stuff, so. Might put that there. And then cut out this boat. Kind of like the boat being here. Should have left that flat. I did like they had a waterfall there, but I couldn't really. Okay, let's see how this looks. Oops. I see it's too much. I gotta cut the blue. Too much blue. A little bit more blue right off of the back part. Perfect. I think that'll work. All right. So we are going to glue this down. Glue the boat down. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Shoot. I don't think I have any paint on here, do I? Yeah, not really. I need to touch it up later, I can always touch it up later. Okay. So, we're going to put the Peter Pan up on top. I think I am going to kind of round it out like it is here. So there's not so much white. See guys, there is a method to my madness. Alright. And then we could put that right above the rainbow. Okay. So, I think I'm going to take score tape for that. So we'll use score tape. Oops, I don't want to use that. That's my fussy cut. Okay. That'll work. So, we are going to lay this out as best I can. Take some of that glue off. I hate this because I'm not good at trying to make things straight. Because I didn't want to cover up the tree. All right. So that's working, okay? Now, I gotta figure out how to do this. All right. Well, I already know I want this on here, but I also want this page on here too. So as you can see, what I already did, I took, instead of painting it, I put a piece of blue paper down on the bottom for the water. So what I am going to do is lay that down, and I'm probably, again, going to have to paint around it. So we're going to use the score tape again. I'm going to move this out of the way. Let that dry for a minute. So we are going to place this down to the bottom as best as I can. It's going to be good enough. Okay. Like I said, I'm going to be painting it anyway. Okay, so now I'm not going to put you through me painting again because it takes me a while. But I wanted to show you that, you know, you can try and continue something along on the edges by painting it. So, okay. Now, how am I going to do this? Because so how I'm going to do this is I am going to make one side bigger than the other. So I have one of my beta readers from the group that I had started on Facebook for Mr. Richard Armitage. She wanted me to send her 5 chapters. And she already read a couple of them. And she gave me, excuse me as I yawn, basically the go ahead. She's like, so far, she's totally drawn into the book. And she can't wait to continue reading. So, I am thinking that's a very good sign. Yeah, I'll have to put something there. Oh, wait a minute. Well, too bad I couldn't put that there. I mean, I could. I wonder if I can fit them flying. Let's see here. I don't know if I can, but we're gonna try. Needless to say, I don't want all of this. I just want the blue area. I can always cut this down. Let's see what we got. I don't know if this is going to work, but we're going to try. It might. I don't have to put that there. That was why I chose this paper, because I liked this paper. I figured it would work perfectly with this blue-green color. Take some of this blue off. I think we're gonna cut right here. Cause I wanna see the fairy dust, but I don't want too much fairy dust. Take this in just a little bit. Alright. Let's try this. Wrong way. That works perfectly, I think. Perfect. Absolutely perfect. Now, I can't put that. You know what I can put? There's Tinkerbell in the moon. Oh, I got it. All right. So we are going to cut out Tinkerbell and the moon. Let's cut this across. Because maybe what I'm thinking I could do. Can I put her? I gotta cut around the moon here. Let's try that. I like. All right. Shave a little off the top here. Sound like I'm giving somebody a haircut. All right. And I think we're good to go. All right. And then we're going to put that one on top. So let me glue this down. Now I gotta find a place for that now. Oh, I wanna use that. I was thinking about putting him down here, but now that he's on here, I don't want to do that. Could I use? London Bridge. That's too, way too big. But I could put that there. Knew there was a reason why I bought these stickers. I know I have other London stickers, but I don't feel like digging for them right now. I was going to put that there, but alright, let me glue this down first. The mind is a going. Let's see here. Right, Tinkerbell. Let's get this glued down. Actually, I think I'm going to go with the way I originally had it, but I can't. There's that other line. I think that's it. I think. Alright, now, let's get these guys in here and glued. I think I'm just going to use the wet glue. think it'd be a lot easier. Let's try this. That is good. Little bit there. There we go. Awesome sauce. Yeah, I did not even see that coming. It just came all at once. Okay, now, what did I say I wanted to do? I want it to not fit. I think it's going to be too big, though. Yeah, I can't. It's too big. I am going to put this here. And you know what? I'm going to take it off its foam piece because I don't want it sticking out so much. Because that's what makes this journal so bulky. Put that. We're going to take London off it. Have okay. So that's pretty good so far because I have no bulk. Alright, let me find, open up my Tinkerbell stuff. Thank you. one do we want to use? Let's see here. You want to use a lighter one? Actually, I'm trying to work around this key. I don't think it's going to work. Unless I don't put. Unless I put sparkle down below. I could. I didn't want to cover up that rose though. Why is it everything you want to use I think we're going to go with that. I think we've got it. Now what are in here? These are the things I ordered from Amazon. These are probably just Best Fairy Friends. Pixie Spirit. You're My Wing Girl. Pixie Party. Those cute little flowers. Butterflies. Spirit. I might put that there. I think we're done with that. I don't know about that though. What about if we put this up here? It's too close to the thing. Better up down here. Yeah, right there. Not keen about that butterfly. That's why I keep looking at it. I think we're gonna put that there. Okay. Glue these puppies down, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to separate these pages, and I know where everything's going, so, alright, so I'll put you over there, I'm going to lay you down flat, we're going to start with this little gem. Now we are going to do sparkle. Okay. This is going up at the top. And since it's got a little bit of a curve in it, we are going to use these handy dandy clips to stick them down. Okay. And then I'm going to put Pixie Spirit down on the bottom. going to put Tinkerbell. So I keep thinking I have about 3 days left on my vacation. I never made it down to the Jersey Shore like I really wanted to. I even wanted to go up to Salem, Massachusetts, which I never got to do. I'm trying to figure out what I'm doing for my last couple of days, because my back has actually been feeling a little bit better. I haven't had as much pain, which is a good thing. Oh, let's see. That is going there. I can so far. Okay. I really wish I could put like something that they're flying over. Can I make it work? You know what? Is this too big? I'm going to take this backing off. And I think I might be good. Do I want to put it on top or on the bottom? I think we might cover it like that. Because then it still gives me a tuck spot. Or, am I better off like that? I think I might be better off like that. Oh, that's perfect because I still have a tuck spot. Alrighty, here we go. A whole bunch of British things the past couple of days. Go figure. Watched something about Scotland Yard. I watched something about the Underground, Westminster. Then I watched a series about the Royals. I like. No, yeah, I am going to use this on here. Okay. I think I'm good on here. I'm going to start putting this on here now. See, Amanda, your clips come out. I use them all the time. They work very well for me. Okay. All right. I like that. I like that a lot. All right. So that worked out well, and I actually was even able to use these. I can't use Cheers, though. I'm not putting that there. I
also watched, what was it about? MI6.
That was really, really interesting, too. That was a really good show. About spies and counterterrorism, and even from way back when with the Cold War, and I mean, it was absolutely fascinating. It was a really, really good show. Okay, since I can't do anything with that until that dries, I'm going to move these off to the side. Problem is, now I got to figure out what's going in next. Oh! Okay.